Did you know that you can call REST endpoints from an Azure SQL database? Maybe you did, but did you also know that you can use it to do things like leverage the power of Azure Logic Apps and other services? Learn all about it this week on Data Exposed MVP Edition. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed MVP Edition. Today, I'm joined by David, MVP in the community. David, why don't you kick us off by telling us a little bit about what you do?
Yeah, 100%, Anna. Thank you for having me today. I've been working in the data analytics space for more than 10 years, always with Microsoft Technologies, and I'm based in the East Coast of Australia in Brisbane. And I'm glad to be here to tell you a little bit about the Azure SQL databases and external REST APIs with Logic Apps.
Awesome. Cool. Well, we are excited to have you here. And the topic for today, as you were talking about, is invoking REST endpoints with Azure Logic Apps, which is something I've actually never seen done before. So I'm actually really excited to learn about it. I love Logic Apps. They're so easy for me to use. So let's get right into it. Tell us a little bit about, you know, what you want to talk about today.
Yeah, definitely. Look, as we've seen during the past, 1 year ago, this became GA, generally available, and it's the availability of us using REST endpoints from the Azure SQL DB. That basically means that from the Azure SQL DB, now you can go and query and execute a lot of the different REST APIs that are available in Azure. This opens a lot of opportunities from an Azure SQL DB point of view, and a lot of different options. For today, we're going to be focusing on the Azure Logic Apps connectors. The main idea is basically that when you are in the Azure SQL DB and you want to execute any of these REST APIs, is that you have an stored proc available to do so. As easy as that. Execute this stored proc, pass the parameters, and you'll be triggering a REST API request to a different service. But let's step back for 1 second. What are the main reasons why we want to do that? So I've seen during the past few years, and this is not something new, for some reason, companies and organizations, they like to store the information across multiple systems. And this creates challenges related to integration. And that translates on data quality problems as well. So I've seen many organizations since my early days where they have to run data quality projects to fix data quality issues. Another type of data quality issue is the information not being available in a specific systems or not being up to date. Let's put a scenario. So imagine that the customer information or the employee information in a company, it might be stored across multiple systems. And sometimes those systems, they don't talk to each other. Now with the REST APIs and Azure SQL DB, we can solve many of these business challenges. And it also opens a new opportunity, which is essentially using Azure SQL DB as a master data hub. A master data hub essentially is a central repository where we have the golden record of the domains that we want to look after. So imagine like a central repository where we have the customer information, and that information is up to date, is correct, is our single source of truth, our golden record, and we're going to send that information to multiple systems. And the same scenario you can apply to other domains. Imagine that the products and services catalog, imagine the employee information, or the stores, the location of the stores. So there are so many data domains that you can use the master data hub approach with Azure SQL DB, just because now we also have the availability to execute REST API endpoints.
Got it. This makes a ton of sense. A quick question for you. When you say master data hub, do you mean that all of the data would now live in Azure SQL database, or like from Azure SQL database, you're able to point to all the, you know, sources of truth where they live today?
Okay, so you have different approaches when building a master data hub. One of them is to have a data repository. So in this case, we'll use Azure SQL DB for storing, as an example, all the customer information. And from that repository, we send information to other systems to keep that information up to date. In a different scenario, you could think that during the past few years, most of the organizations that I worked with, they wanted to create a customer database, right? And they allow their customers to go and update their information. So basically, in that scenario, you could consider that you want to use the that repository as the master data hub in Azure SQL DB, and then send that information to other systems to keep it up to date. So imagine, as a customer, I update my information in a customer portal, and then that information flows to the accounting system. It flows to the customer relationship management system. Everything happens automatically, but the orchestration happens from Azure SQL DB.
Got it. Makes sense. Okay, cool.
All right. So this is a great scenario, right? So before we had to go and tap into different tools for orchestrating the data integration between different systems, but with the REST APIs and Azure Logic Hubs, now we have a scenario that we can cover. Why do you want to use Azure SQL DB, basically? So, you know, many of us, many organizations, they build customer databases, or they are looking at implementing a master data management system or a master data hub, or they are looking at storing reference data. We can definitely use Azure SQL DB for that. But on top of that, now we have access to execute Azure Logic Hubs. And one of the key benefits of Azure Logic Hubs is that it has more than 400 connectors, and it can execute any REST API endpoint, essentially. That means that from Azure SQL DB, we trigger an Azure Logic Hubs that goes and execute a specific activity in a different system. Let me show you an example. In this example, so we have a customer repository that acts as a master data hub. We have the customer information. And with the REST endpoint, then we can go and trigger the Azure Logic Hubs to sync and update information on other systems. So this is a simple scenario that was not possible before the REST APIs. But what do you think, Anna? Do you want me to go and show a demo? How about this?
Yeah, absolutely. I would love to see a demo, and I'm sure our viewers would as well.
Okay, let's go and do it. So let me share my code in Azure Data Studio. And here I show you a simple solution. So we're connected to a database on Azure SQL DB. We have a table with the phone information. And what we want to do is basically to create a trigger. So after this table is updated, we want to go and execute an Azure Logic Hubs by using the REST API endpoint. You can see that here we find all the variables that we need, and we do some comparisons. Yes, what we're doing here is just getting the information, the phone number, the email address of the customer for which the record has been updated. And the end goal is basically just to create the parameters that we need to execute that REST endpoint. So that means when we're executing this store proc here, we're calling an Azure Logic Hubs, and we're passing the values that we're expecting in the Azure Logic Hubs. So once that we've done this in the triggers, and you can see all the flexibility that you have in here. So we're doing this from a trigger, but you could have this in a store proc, you could have this, on overnight batchly update. You have a lot of flexibility to go and execute the Azure Logic Hubs with the REST API endpoints. And remember, today we're talking about Azure Logic Hubs, but the reality is that you can go and execute Azure functions. You can go and call OpenAI models. So there are many other services that you can use the same approach for. And I think that opens a lot of opportunities for businesses who have control over their data, and they are taking advantage of Azure SQL DB.
I love it.
So one that we've done all the hard work, which is writing code, do you want to know another thing? So when you use the OpenAI models and Copilot, they're able to give you most of this code that
really?
You see in the screen. Yeah, I haven't done much of the coding myself, to be honest. I did apply a few changes here and there, but this is code written by Copilot, essentially.
That's awesome.
All right. So once that we've done this work, let me go and show you a quick demo on how the information is being updated, and then I'll show you the actual logic apps. Let me jump into a different screen. So in this scenario, we have three databases. So we have the customer database on the left. We're using our legacy AdventureWorks. And then we have a system, which is the CRM database and the accounting database. As I query the CRM database or the accounting database, you'll see that the phone number across all those databases is the same.
Right.
And now let's say that we want to, Anna, give me your phone number. Let's put it here.
No? Not going to fall for that one.
Okay, cool. That's fine. Let me make up a number. Let's be 149, and we'll put dashing in there. So we're going to update this table. And then we're going to go to the CRM system.
Yes. Wow.
Can see that the information has been updated already.
It was so fast, like not even a second later.
That's it. And that's Azure Logic Apps. Azure Logic Apps allow you to do near real-time system-to-system integration, application-to-application integration, B2B. It gives you so many opportunities to do so. So let's go and have a quick look at the Azure Logic Apps and how that was built. So remember, so the triggered started once that we updated the information. So that essentially went and triggered these logic apps from here, which is it has a specific endpoint, and then it's going to call another Azure Logic Apps to sync the information across systems, and then it's going to send the customer an email to highlight that the information has been updated for the customer. When we call the other logic apps, you can see that we pass, in both scenarios, we're passing the parameters, the request of the body that we need. This is what we built in the trigger. And when we call the other logic apps, you can see it's a simple solution to show the capabilities, but you can extend this as required. So it goes and updates the CRM information and the accounting information. But the
how we were able to kind of see it all in real time, like almost real time.
That's it. This happens in less than a second. That's how powerful Azure Logic App is. But if you wanted to extend this solution with one of the Azure Logic Apps connectors, you can see how many options you have to go and orchestrate your solution and perform your workloads. That's how powerful it is to combine now Azure SQL DB and Azure Logic Apps with the REST API endpoints.
Wow, awesome. Well, David, I learned so much. This was so cool. I'm going to go try it out myself. Hopefully your code is somewhere that we can share with users, but if it's not, then I'm going to use Copilot. But if you have any, do you have any final tips or tricks for folks who are just getting started, maybe with either the Invoke external endpoint or the Azure Logic Apps?
Yeah, look, I highly suggest all the information I'll show you today on how to execute the REST API endpoints is available in the Microsoft LAN documentation. So I recommend go and have a look at the store prog, set up a test environment with Azure SQL DB that is really easy to get started, and give it a go. You know, we learn by doing. That's how it is.
Awesome. I love it. Well, David, thanks again so much for coming on the show. To our viewers, if you like this episode, go ahead and give it a like, leave us a comment, and let us know what you plan to do with this capability. We'll put some links in the description for you to go learn more, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.